Today, we're going to share with you something quite astonishing. A pilot study that was conducted in a hospital in Madrid by deploying artificial intelligence. My promise to you today is that in 10 minutes, you will know at least three things that you didn't know before, and then you will have some insights about what the future of healthcare, especially in dermatology, is going to be like in, let's say, 5 years. So let's start by setting some things clear. There's a huge problem. There's a really scarce amount of dermatologists. This is quite common in most medical specialties, but also in dermatology. This results in a heavily increased burden for the doctor themselves. So today is only not me, but also Dr. Elena Sanchez-Largo, who will be presenting this technology. And she'll be able to tell you about this increase in the burden of care. But I can tell you that if doctors were not doing what they're doing out of passion, they would not put up with the stress because they have a really big workload. Obviously, also the patient pays a price regarding this. So most data is from before the pandemic. So you could see around 3 months of waiting. But after the pandemic, patients are waiting up to 1 year in most cases. And I think it's pretty clear why this is not ideal. And in fact, it's dangerous for many conditions. And the solution has to be digital. It can only be digital, but also patients want it to be digital. In several studies that were conducted asking patients how would they like to receive care, most of them said that they prefer a digital solution, a synchronous, digital, remote, and most of them especially said that they would like a hybrid model between in-person consultations, but also digital consultations. So that's why we created this tool. It's called Legit.Health. It's a medical device, it's classified as a medical device, that has been co-designed, co-developed with leading dermatologists to tackle the needs of both the physicians and also the patients. Before explaining what it does, I have a question for you, if you don't mind me asking. So look at this picture. What would you say this person has out of those three options? Okay, well done, well done. So I hear someone saying psoriasis, and well done, it is indeed psoriasis. So we call this diagnosis. This process is called diagnosis, and is precisely performing this task in your mind, or in our case, with artificial intelligence. Actually, we're doing this with not only skin conditions, with a lot of conditions, even facial palsy, malignant conditions, and even wounds. But the second question is this one. How much psoriasis would you say this person has? Yeah, this one's more difficult. You all seem puzzled, and indeed it is more difficult because, as you can see, measuring the severity is a very different task. Luckily for you, all the answers were right, kind of. So what we're doing is algorithms that help measure what is the severity very precisely in the parameters that are relevant to the pathology. So we can tell you there's 32% erythema, which is redness. We can tell you that the surface is X amount, and we can tell you that it's 2% worse than it was yesterday. How is this done today? Severity estimation. Severity estimation is key. It's key to deciding what is the treatment for the patient. It's key to deciding if the patient must be referred from the primary care physician to the specialist. And the way this is done today is mostly by pen and paper questionnaires. So doctors look, as you just did, look at an elbow, look at a face, and they decide, okay, erythema, 3 out of 4. Desquamation, 2. So this is visual estimation. And it's usually very tedious. It takes between 10 and 12 minutes to fill out the scoring systems. In, let's say, 2015, we started seeing digital calculators, which at least do the scoring, the sum of the score is done automatically. But still, it's up to the doctor deciding if the erythema is 4, let's say. So what we're doing is we're doing this automatically by using artificial intelligence that looks at pictures of the condition and extracts the intensity of the clinical sign. So that is how we are helping doctors help their patients. And this is very important because you are hearing artificial technology. Our approach, and we obviously think we're right, is the artificial intelligence, the AI, must always be an aid to the doctor. The doctor will always be the key stakeholder in the provision of care for patients, and the AI has to be a tool that helps them reduce the waiting list and so on. And that's, I think, precisely why I'm very happy to introduce today Dr. Elena Sanchez-Largo. She's a dermatologist. She's an expert in the field, specifically in psoriasis. And she's going to tell you more about the pilot we've been conducting.
Thank you very much, Sai, for introducing me and for your presentation. It's a pleasure for me to be here to briefly explain the result of this study, to explain its usefulness in clinical practice. After a short period of time, we recruited 180 patients, and we can see that acne patients group was the largest. It represented 65% of the total. Possibly, the reason why this group is larger than the rest is due to the age of the patients with this pathology, with better accessibility to technologies. How does it work? To start, the care provider registers on the platform the patients, and the patients save their password and accept the terms and conditions. After that, they are able to upload photographs from home. Legit.Health algorithms process that photograph, and artificial intelligence can analyze the quality of the image, can identify a potential condition, and can measure the severity, like Taig. With all this information, the doctor receives a diagnostic report with a possible condition, and we can confirm it or select another diagnosis. The doctor can adjust the premalignancy score and add clarifications. With this information, the patients can see a version of that report with information about their dermatosis, the disease progression, information with doctor note or treatment guidelines. And there is an autonomous cycle in which the patients receive instructions by the doctor to upload photographs and receive information that encourages them. We can see here the high adherence to the applications. This data represents how many of the patients who registered on the platform were active in sending images after the first month. And we can see that more than the 80% of the patients decided to use that technology to send the photographs. After the pilot study, we did several questionnaires to the patients. That questionnaire showed that ease of use was one of the most valuable of this technology. Secondly, the patients highlight the degree of satisfaction with the care provider. And that's meant a lot to me because it reflects that patients have a positive assessment of connecting with the doctor. A telematic assistant is a new form of that connection and maybe can be the future to maintain, to keep the relationship between doctors and patients. And I want to meet someone. His name is Gary.
During that time, I suffered an accident and was unable to attend my meetings and appointments at the hospital. But with the new technology, I was able to keep in contact with my doctor, my physician, and continue my medical treatment, which I was not able to get to the hospital to do. It is a great thing we can count on new technologies so patients can keep in contact with the medical personnel and maintain their treatments.
So thank you, Gary. After that, and to finish, which are the main advantages of this technology for me? So it implements telematic monitoring of chronic dermatosis without the need to go to the hospital. So telematic assistance facilitates work-life balance, like we could see in this example. And patients have the possibility to have their own register of their pathology. And you can see the progression, the evolution of the dermatosis through these photographs. And it's very important to the adherence to treatment because they can see the difference between the beginning and the actual situation. And the patients have the possibility of connecting with the doctor easily. And we can, with all these information, make decisions early. For example, we can change the treatment if it was necessary. And all these advantages represent for me the same items that patients highlight in the questionnaires: the ease of use and the satisfaction with the care provider. And now, Ty, will explain some of the technicalities of the tool.
Most of you possibly are interested in the technological part. Indeed, always integrating the tool into an existing system is a really big challenge. A big challenge technologically speaking, but also in a personal level, because the people using it must be engaged with it. So for this particular pilot, what we did is doctors used the standalone web application that we developed, meaning that it was not actually plugged in to their day-to-day system. This is, of course, not ideal, it's because it was a pilot, but the ideal thing is usually to connect this technology, this artificial intelligence, via API into their system. And we did two ways of achieving this. So either you can have what we call the JSON only, in which you would send images via API REST to the algorithm and then return a big JSON file with all the clinical data. But we also do deep link. The deep link meaning that we embed some of the UI of the application, of the data visualization, into the software of the medical center, which is very useful. And with this method, it's really great because you get all the data plus the advanced interface. So you would be getting things like a diagnostic report, you will be getting data about the image quality, as she was mentioning, meaning that if a patient uploads a picture that doesn't have enough quality, the algorithm steps in and tells the patient, hey, could you maybe try doing it again with the flash? You will get the severity measure and even the pre-malignancy, which is very, very useful in detecting cancer at an early stage before it's too late. And I'm happy to say, and you will be glad to know, that all of this is, of course, GDPR compliant. So GDPR is I think is a main thing in all industries, but remember that in healthcare we're speaking about data that is very sensitive pertaining the health of the patient. So this is actually a standardized way of communicating, especially images, between the patient and the doctor.
Maybe you can think that this is the future, but for me, but for us, this is the present.
Yeah, so join us in helping doctors help their patients and making this the present in more medical centers so we can improve patients' quality of life.